Good morning, children. Today we are going to start with the second chapter of civics, that is understanding secularism. We know in the previous chapter when we did the important features of the constitution, the last point what we discussed was secularism. So what is a secularism? If I ask a question, how would you feel if children in your locality tell you that their parents have asked them not to play with you because you belong to a particular community? Yes, you will feel bad. That is where the importance of the secularism comes. The Indian Constitution contains fundamental rights that protect us against the state power as well as against the tyranny of the majority. The Indian Constitution allows the individual to live by their religion, religious beliefs and practices without any interference. The secularism refers to the separation of religion from the state. We can also say the secularism is a non-interference or the non-intervention of religion in matters relating to the politics, society, education, etc. In short, a state adopts an unbiased approach towards all religion. Now moving ahead, why is it important to separate the religion from the state? The first important point of separating religion from the state is smooth functioning of democracy. In present day scenario, usually various religious communities are there in our country. We know that our country is a diversified country. We have different religions, different section of people. Among these different groups, one faction will be in majority. Once these groups acquire political power, then it can be easy for them to use these powers and dominate the weaker section of the society, or to harass the minority. Therefore, for the proper working of the democratic system, it is important to separate the religion from state. The most important aspect of the secularism is its separation of religion from the state power. Secondly, to protect fundamental rights. Another significant point is the separation of religion and state to defend the liberty of citizen. This means that everyone should be free to live or embrace any religion of his or her choice. The third one, to preserve India's unity. By giving equal importance to all religion, our constitution promotes harmony between different religious groups. As written in the book, another reason that is important to separate religion from the state in democratic society is because we need to protect the freedom of individual to exist from their religious, embrace another religion, or have the freedom to interpret the religious teaching differently. Now, what is Indian secularism? As per the constitution, a secular state has got certain goals that it guarantees. The first one, to check dominance of one religious community over another religious community, that one religious community does not dominate the another one. Second, check oppression of some members of the other members of the same religious groups. Sometimes few people are more powerful in the same religious community and they dominate the weaker ones in the same community. The third one, the state will neither enforce any religion nor take away the religious freedom of the citizen. That means that the state does not enforce any particular religion nor take away the religious freedom of the individual. The Indian state does a lot to promote secularism through the policy of non-interference. It means that the communities does not interfere, state does not interfere in their customs and practices. The constitution forbids its practice in any form as it violates the principle of equality centered to democracy. To make the point of non-interference clear, you can see in this picture the boys, they are coming together, they are going for a scooter ride. You can see one man is wearing a helmet, the other one is a sick person and he is wearing a turban. Since it is a religious practice of Sikh to wear a turban, the state will not interfere or will not compel him to wear the helmet. For Sikhs, wearing a pagri is a very important part of their religion. The government cannot force them to wear a helmet. Children, hope you have understood this second chapter. Complete all the question answers in your classwork copy, which have been uploaded in the eCare. Now, good morning, children. Since your summer holidays are going to begin from 23rd of May, I am here to explain you the holiday homework for history and civics. The first one, you have to collect the picture and all the information regarding the person who has carved out a way for an independent state after the downfall of the Mughal Emperor. So, you have to collect the information, write it down and prepare a folder. The folder, you don't need to purchase it from the market. You can prepare it. Handmade will do. After the downfall of the Mughal Emperor, the people who declare themselves as a ruler, you have to write the information about them, their territory and their achievements. Coming to the second one, you have to write an account of the historical building which is still there in your state. It can be built during the British period or during the Mughal period. It has to be done on a chart paper. You have to draw the monument and write the information regarding these. Okay. In civics, you have to prepare a poster outlining the preamble of India. It again has to be done on a chart paper. And you have to write the important features of the Indian constitution. The last one is you have to find out different religious practices that is going on in your neighborhood. Your neighbors will be practicing different religion. You have to collect the information of any two religion. You have to write their customs, their god, their holy book, their important festivals and the rituals. It has to be done in your classwork copy and you have to give an account of any two religion. Hope you have understood how to do your history civics summer vacation holiday homework. Stay home and stay safe. Thank you.